the survivor theme. But then we thought there's so many worldly things about that TV show that we thought we could change the theme and make it into how do Christians survive in a world as it is today. We came up with a really neat atmosphere in the fire pit, and we had bamboo and flags and kind of a tiki theme. And tribal council, really, we made that into our worship service. But we made it in a way that the kids understood we have to bring ourselves before God and look at ourselves. But then some of the really fun stuff for me was coming up with the food challenges and the brain challenges.
Yo, we're just there for doing time to life, big, you see me?
I gotta slow down. Stop for a second, take a look around. And I gotta take time to hear that little voice inside. Saying I came to
give. Don's got some great video of things the kids may not necessarily like, but we made them try to eat and see if they could get beyond the things, the mental and the taste that they had to go through.
So go into life, big. I wanna do life, big.
All the kids really stuck in there and tried to eat it. A few couldn't hack it. But most notably, I think Terry is the one that couldn't hack it the most.
Yeah, it's like a new day. Woke up to hear you say, I came to give you life. So spread your wings and fly. Now go and show no fear. You are enough to change the atmosphere. So go and do life.
So one of the things we like to do here at Camp Bellevue is to put in a exercise / guided prayer path. We have a lot of people come to for a spiritual retreat, and so we want to offer some places where they can meditate and pray. The kids this week with the camp have been working on 5 prayer stations. Each prayer station will have scripture verses that will give them a thought or something that they can meditate on. Right now we're standing in front of one for the Hacienda of Hope, which is a children's home, and it has the passage from James that talks about pure religion is taking care of widows and orphans. I'm excited to see the prayer stations coming together, and they're looking good.
Class was broken out by color group. We had 10 different color groups. Each individual class, of course, had an instructor and a helper. And additionally, for those that were English speaking only, we had a translator assigned to every one of those classes.
Ricardo, tell me about some of the class material.
Well, the class material had to evolve in order to cover the theme that we chose for this year, which was survivor. And we looked at Francis Chan. He has a basic serious material that really lends itself to actually talk about how Christians survive in this world. Yet specifically, the very first day we talked about the Holy Spirit and what it does for us. We talked about the fear of God and how knowledge begins with the fear of God. So every day had a video that built on the lesson, like sports figures and others who basically interview themselves and talk about the challenges that they've had in life and how they've overcome them by making themselves second to following Christ.
Nicole, en cuanto tú has hecho esta confesión de fe, yo te voy a bautizar en el nombre del Padre y del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. Para que recibas el don del Espíritu Santo y tus pecados te sean perdonados.
Well, I just heard the news today. It seems my life is gonna change. I close my eyes, begin to pray, then tears of joy stream down my face. Days will come when you don't have the strength you're not worth anything. Wondering if you ever could be loved. And if they truly saw your heart, they'd see too much. You're beautiful. You're beautiful. You are made for so much more than all of this. You're beautiful. You're beautiful. You are treasured, you are sacred, you are His.
Uno, dos, tres.
What would you like to tell the people back home?
That they need to experience some sort of mission trip in their life. It doesn't have to be Ecuador necessarily, but they need to get out and go see the world and see how different people are living, because it opens your eyes.
To come on a mission trip somewhere, just so that you can get out of your own comfort zone, do something different that you know, you don't normally do, and this is a good one.
If you can't go, continue to support this trip, because it is a worthwhile cause and it touches the lives of many kids in Ecuador, which in turn touches the lives of their families.
I will tell you that Diana and Rick have it so well organized and take such good care of us that you can do it too.
Walking into the cabin and seeing the girls have their Bibles out, studying their memory verses for the next day.
I just love serving the children here in Ecuador.
So Robert, why do you come to Ecuador?
I come because I see it as fulfilling Jesus' call to go to all the world and teach the gospel.
I come down here because growing up, when we came every summer, it became, I don't know, part of my life. I grew up here just as much as the campers grew up here, and every time I come down, it's like seeing old family, in a sense.
She showed her light with me, and she are a good friend. Thanks.
I vote for Abigail because she participates in the class, and she helps to us to understand more about Jesus.